Well, electricity prices have only just gone up, but they're about to soar again. This time it will be a 17% rise from August, forcing the average family to find an extra $225 a year.
For single parent Mikey Kruger, even running a heater is becoming a luxury she can barely afford.
With electricity rising, food prices going up, petrol, transport, it's very challenging.
And it's about to get even harder, with electricity rising by 17.4% from August. The price increase will see medium users slugged an extra $226 a year, the total annual bill more than $1,500, while small business faces a hike of $434 a year.
They're huge chunks of somebody's income. If you're on a lower income or a fixed income, that's an incredible amount that you have to meet.
The Essential Services Commission, which sets the price, says ETSA maintenance upgrades are behind much of the increase.
We acknowledge there may be some short-term pain and we urge consumers to shop around.
Gas is also up by 14%, with welfare agencies now helping a new type of client.
We now see people who might be self-funded retirees who have really started to feel the pinch, other people who are working poor.
SACOS is concerned the cost pressures coincide with the axing of 44 councillors from the government's anti-poverty unit.
It's just not fair. We can seem to find money for things like, you know, football grounds or bridges over whatever, when basic people out there are doing it tough.
The government says it's organising funding for welfare agencies to cover the job cuts. James Wakeland, 10 News.